Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this video we are going to talk about names. More specifically, how you can set your app name in iTunes Connect in your project, and most importantly, what not to do. So, without further ado, let's get started. Okay. Now, we are going to talk about names, and for that we are going to need a new project. So let's open up our Xcode project here and let's create a brand new project. It could be a single view application, that is great. And NamesMania should be our product name. Okay, now let's click on next, and I will just simply drop it onto my desktop, and I will not create a Git repository for this tutorial. It is a very simple Xcode tutorial. Okay, now as you can see here, we have some areas where the NamesMania occurs. More specifically here, our NamesMania, our folders here, our project, our targets, and our bundle identifier and display name. Now, what you should be aware of is that the display name is the one you should start with, and that is, well, kind of the most important part of this Xcode project. And I will just type in here mania. So that is how you can change it, or maybe go to your info file here or here and change the bundle display name. Where is it? Bundle display name here. Okay, but let's go back to the usual way of doing things. Go to targets and general. So here we have our bundle display name, and that is displayed under your icon. As you can see here, I have AR magic, anti candy, and for some it is much longer, because if we just type in here mania along this display name, and we just simply run it on our iPhone 10 simulator, then we can see that it will be, well, shrunken down and with a three dots. Let's just see that it is running. So now let's just stop it and let's take a look at our simulator here. And mania long this and so on. It is not quite what you want when you want your users to see on their devices. So instead we just simply type in here mania, or something that is very associative with your app's name. Maybe you are changing anti candy crunch and you are not using candy. You are using, let's say, blocks of wood, then you would want to add the display name blocks. Now, this is the first thing. Now, one last thing that I want to show you is how to change this project name. Well, you don't really want to change the project name, because it doesn't really matter what you upload to iTunes Connect as in terms of the project name. What it matters, what really matters, is your bundle display name. It should be a unique one, and of course your display name in terms of this tutorial. But for tutorial purposes, let's change our project. So select your project and let's name this NamesMania 2, okay? And hit return, and it will ask where you want to make those changes. Let's rename this so you may see this. And let's see. Now, as you can see, the project, the target's name, and the project name here has been changed. The NamesMania, however, wasn't changed. And that is how it should be, because this is a folder name. Now, if you had changed this, it's okay. Maybe you don't want to do this, because it is quite irrelevant in terms of naming your app and what your users will see. Now, this is what your users will see when they install your app. Now, I want to show you how you can set the name of your app what your users will search for in iTunes Connect. So let's go to iTunes Connect here. So once we are at our iTunes Connect login portal, let us just log in and let's wait for that. And now let me just select my own here instead of my clients. And here we have my apps, and I will choose one of the earliest layer, let's say ASD Magic. Okay, here we have it. And once it is loaded, you can see that here we have our localizable information, and this is the name that it will appear on the App Store when users search for your app. So make sure here you set up the name you want to change, the name you want to see on the App Store, and of course a subtitle, because now you can have subtitles too, but that is for another series. Okay, hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel down below if you haven't already done so. And as always, I will see you in the next one.